a covenant. It's on a bond for life. And all my business was the easiest song to write. It's my confession in the rhyme, my testament, and I just want to do my thing. As I talk about a feeling that cannot be explained, or a love that cannot be explained in a measurement of time. Some say it was a blessing in disguise. Scratch that, girl, you a lesson from the skies. And I...
Festivities wrapping up. The crowd is electric, and we'll be back to get it going right after this. From Vince Scully Avenue, welcome to Dodger Stadium. MLB The Show brings you the National League Championship Series. The Atlanta Braves taking on the Los Angeles Dodgers. John Ciambi and Chris Singleton with you. We're looking forward to what's sure to be a dramatic Game 3, Chris.
And Boog, this is as close to an elimination game as you can get without it actually being one. Going down 3-0 would more or less just end this thing. So this game's going to tell us whether we're going to have a real series in store for us or if we're just going to be packing our bags and going home.
A lot of people feel these teams are more evenly matched the first two games would indicate. So we'll see if we get a bounce back performance in this one. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Just about ready to go, and on the hill, Yoshinobu Yamamoto. What's the scouting report on him?
Well, the hammer is in effect, and he sets it up so nicely because of the velocity on the fastball. We'll elevate that and then break you off when he's ahead in the count. What I love about him, you get into the later innings of the ball game, and the velocity seems to go up.
Okay, all set to go. And now here is Ronald Acuna Jr. The pitch. Outside low, and we're underway in game three.
First pitch, 7-0-6.
And the right-hander deals. Wouldn't chase that time.
He's been raking in recent games, and a big reason why, getting ahead in counts. He's been able to do that consistently, and you see the results.
That one missed.
For whatever reasons, this is a hitter that performs better in night games. We'll see what he brings in this one.
Next offering is in for a strike. On the corner for a strike. Hard ground ball, base knock. And the postseason success continues for him.
Just so sound in his mechanics. Hits against a firm front side. And the hands just continue to carry through the middle of the field.
Ozzie Albies up to the plate. He was late there. Strike one.
Hold one for count.
Ground ball to first, could be two. To second, there's one. Plenty of time at first, that's a double play.
For me, that's one of the toughest double plays to turn on the infield. The first baseman has to get inside, create a throwing lane to hit that middle infielder to start the double play, and then from there, completing it back to first. Really good job all the way around.
Michael Harris, next up for the Braves. And first offering is fouled off. Two outs. In the air out to center. Outman under this one. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. And the Dodgers are coming up to hit. No score. You're watching the National League Championship Series on the show. Back here at Dodger Stadium. And on the mound now, Charlie Morton. What should we keep an eye on here?
Very dominant his last time out. Picked up the win. Only allowed one run. These guys would love to see him back on his game in this one.
Here comes Freddie Freeman up to hit.
The first base.
Obviously a guy who makes good contact, hits for average. But one of the things in today's game, the value in the fact that he hits both righties and lefties. They're so reliant on the matchups nowadays, Chris. And it's huge when you don't have to sit a guy or platoon him.
When you can hit, you know, both sides in terms of pitcher's arms, you're a guy that it's hard to take out of the lineup, and I think it's very important today when everything is under the microscope.
Left-hand batter waits. Pulls the string with the changeup, struck him out. James Outman steps to the plate for the Dodgers. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike. One out, base is empty. And there's a rocket into the outfield. Around first and hustling for second. And he's in with a stand-up double.
All over that one right there. Really good swing right there. He got a pitch that he knew he could handle. Allowed himself to stay back just a tad bit longer. And he hit the ball on the screws.
One down. Mookie Betts steps to the plate for the Dodgers. The shortstop takes a ball. Man at second. Hard grounder into the outfield for a nine. Into third now. So runners at the corners and one out.
He was all over that.
Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team to bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep.
Runners on the corners with one gone. Here's Max Muncy, that funky Muncy. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
The last thing he wants is to hit the ball on the ground, but I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for a double play in this spot.
Two on, one out. And now two and nothing.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
And another ball.
Knowing that this hitter's got holes in his swing, because he's got so much power, pitcher still can get a little too tight, afraid to make a mistake.
And fouled off. Runners at the corners, one away. Here in game three of the NLCS. That one finds the zone. Good count now.
Well, in this situation with a runner on first, less than two outs, some say, hey, get the ground ball, double play with two strikes. Some people say get the strikeout. I think you just execute your pitch with the best pitch you possibly can and let the result be what it's going to be.
So bases loaded with one away. Next up, the Dodgers catcher, Will Smith. Golden opportunity right here. That one catches the zone. It's 0-1. The pitch. And it's even up. All loaded up here in game three. Big swing and a miss.
Well, that's that slope right there. Doing extremely well. Talk about just a ton of breaks.
Got him! Huge strikeout there.
Certainly a strikeout situation right there. The infield playing back, and this pitcher has to step up and get the swing and miss. Really nice job of attacking the hitter at the plate. Pretty big two-out at bat coming up now.
Here's Jason Hayward. First pitch misses.
Count 4-0.
Outman, the runner at third. Betts on second. Muncie at first. Two out of the inning. So two balls and no strikes.
Pressure's on right here. 2-0 count. Base is loaded. You don't want to fall to a three-ball count and then walk in a run. He's got to challenge the hitter right here.
And that's a strike. Righty to the plate.
Thank you.
Comes up empty as he chases that one into dirt. Out at the plate. He tries to steal home, and that ends the inning.
Well, needed a big strikeout to get out of danger. Turned to the deception of that changeup. Great execution. Really sold it with the arm speed. Had his opponent way out on that front foot.
And we're back. And now the first baseman, Matt Olson.
If you don't get ahead in the count, you can forget about having any success against him.
Nothing like postseason baseball. There's a buzz in the air. Every pitch seems bigger. It's truly special. Swings through that.
There really is a different feel to the postseason. I only got 5 games of postseason action in my playing career, but I treasured each of them.
And there's a ball. Ripped into right center. Base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock.
Here's Austin Riley. Just missed. And the righty deals. Swing and a miss. And a count one and one. Carl Dixon working the plate in this one.
You know, we often hear and talk about umpires being a pitcher's umpire, but Boo Dixon, maybe a little bit more hitter-friendly than most. He's kind of tight on the corners, so we'll see if that comes into play at all in this one.
And another ball.
Well, he might have to look for a different put-away pitch right here, 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times in this at-bat, so might have it timed up and ready for it.
That misses, and the count's full. Second inning here, no score. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
With that kind of velocity, an elevated fastball, even if it's still in the strike zone, can be tough for hitters to get on top of.
Here's Marcelo Zuna. Fastball for a strike. 0-1. Kicks and fires.
Ball down.
There's a swing and a drive. And that gets down into the gap. And it gets by him. Here comes Olson around third. He scores and they have the lead. 1-0.
That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and lifted into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a cool stroke.
Here's Jared Kelnick. Late on that fastball.
0-1 for count.
One out and a runner at second here in the top of the second.
One
and misses. And now it's even, one and one. Comes up empty. That's strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Swing and a ball lifted in the air, left field, pretty well struck. This one's got a chance. Gone! A two-run shot, and they add a pair. It's 3-0.
And that shot makes their grip on the lead even tighter. Well, not every home run is a majestic blast off the bat, and even though he hit it pretty well, it was anything but a sure thing to get out. But today, the conditions were right. He got just enough of it, and I think the backspin really helped that thing carry.
Here's Sean Murphy, and it's fouled away. Still only one out here in the inning. Swing and a miss.
No ball, two strikes.
Got him swinging for the strikeout. The high heat, too much on that one.
That was a pretty good pitch. Top of the strike zone. We're seeing more fastballs in that location. Hitters, especially with two strikes, have to be ready to pull the trigger.
Here's Orlando Arcia. This to third. Muncy sends it to first, and that'll do it. They strike for three in the inning, two on this two-run home run. It's now 3-0. This is the National League Championship Series on the show. Bottom of the second, now the left fielder, Teoscar Hernandez.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
Breaking ball in there for a strike.
A 3-0 lead is great, but you can't get too comfortable. Got to stay aggressive, keep attacking hitters, try to cruise through this ballgame.
Yeah, he's down 0-2 as he swings through it.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand looks so good, and then by the time he gets in the hitting zone, hard to get the barrel to it.
On the ground, and it's through for a hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
I'd say a mistake pitch in an 0-2 count. Too good of a pitch to hit right there. You have to expand the zone. Keep that leadoff man off first base.
Andy Pajas digs in now. On a line, base hit. Harris fires it in quickly, and it's now first and second to start the inning.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. Other than ripping one into the gap or blasting one over the wall, there are a whole lot of hits that are more satisfying than a nice line drive in the center field, so that definitely felt good.
Here's Kike Hernandez. Next offering popped in the air, right field. And Acuna able to make the grab. And there's one down.
Now batting, first baseman, Freddie Freeman.
Freddie Freeman up to the dish. He's 0-1.
Freddie Freeman delivered a masterclass in 2023. Freeman and Betts fed off of each other's success, and it helped Freeman produce a 977 OPS, 29 home runs, and more than 100 RBIs. That's a great season.
That's out to center field. Harris has a beat on it. He makes the catch, and there's two down.
Now battle the center fielder. Outman.
So first and second with two outs. James Outman steps to the plate for the Dodgers. Doubled in his first AB. Swings through that one.
First pitch strike right there for him. He's going to have to do that consistently if he's going to give any length to his skipper.
That one ripped. That's a fair ball down the right field line. One run is in. Coming home. The relay throw. He'll score. Two runs are in, and they trail by one.
Pick
sets himself up a couple of ribbies. Ripped out down the line and kept it fair. And even when you hit it that far out front, you still have to keep your hands tight to your body so you don't hook around that baseball and put it in foul territory. And that right there was perfect.
Here's Mookie Betts now. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads.
Nope.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. And there's the strike. That misses, and it's 2-1. Man on second, two down. Inside, almost got him.
Get ready for some action here. Good RBI guy at the plate. Runners in scoring position. And a hitter's count.
That smash toward center. Makes a nice grab and a full sprint. And that's the third out. But they'll pick up a couple runs here, both coming on this two-run double. It's now a 3-2 ball game. Back here in L.A., and here is Ronald Acuña Jr. The line of the pitch. Acuña, in his seventh season, 26 years old, and he won the Silver Slugger in his position in the National League last year. And a swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
Couldn't ball, chase that time. Swing and a miss at the splitter, and it's a strikeout.
Well, that's the effect of the splitter that you're looking for on the mound. Really nice pitch right there, and had him out in front over the top. I'm sure the batter was thinking he was getting something else, perhaps a fastball with a little more straight and velo to it.
Here is Ozzie Albies up to hit. He's 0-1. A little out front there as he swings through it. Good eye right there. And that is cut on and missed. And that's strike two.
One ball. Two strikes.
One down, base is empty. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. Two gone now.
Tasked with one, two, and three to start this inning, but no trouble so far. I'm sure he'd love to strike out the side here. Make a little statement, but you got to be composed in this spot. Focus on getting this next guy. You got two good outs. Want to get the third one and avoid the middle of that lineup coming up with a base runner. Could become dangerous.
Harris now at the plate as he swings through strike one.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
Two outs, base is empty. And 1-2.
One ball, two strikes, down.
And another ball. Swings and misses, struck him out. Braves are set down 1-2-3, and it remains a 3-2 ball game. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now it's the Dodger cleanup hitter, Max Muncy. And a pitch. That misses the zone, and it's 1-0.
Ball one, no strike.
And a swing and a miss there.
The baseball is coming out of his hand very well. He's been able to paint all four corners, but really good ride at the top of the zone. Hitters have to respect that. Very difficult pitch to hit.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
The batter.
And up to the plate is Will Smith. His first at-bat was a strikeout. On the ground to third, and it's through for a hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Well, clearly he was ready to hit right there. Just found a way to slap that ball down the third baseline. That's really excellent back control, and it kind of goes back to all those drills you see hitters do off the tee where it's placed in different spots. That was just nice.
Runner on at first with one gone. Now it's going to be Jason Hayward. Oh, he doesn't get the call. Ball one. Tying run is at first here in the last half of the third.
Ball two.
Next offering is downstairs.
Two pitches have been down in the zone. Pitcher clearly trying to get that ground ball double play. But in this count, you're going to have to give in, elevate his pitches, and get back into this at bat.
2 balls, 1 strike.
The 2-1. Grounder might be two. There's one.
That's out.
And that's two. No runs, one hit, no errors, and no one left. Game three moves on to the fourth. It's the Braves 3 and the Dodgers 2. Back here at Chavez Ravine, John Ciampi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Matt Olson. Yamamoto back to work. Swings and misses. That's strike one. And that's outside.
You know, these Braves doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way, and I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of them. It's not just the three runs they've already scored, and on top of that, they forced the starter to throw more pitches than he wanted to at this point of the game.
That one just misses.
And that pitch count is impactful because if they can keep making him work hard out there, it may force the bullpen to get involved a little sooner rather than later.
And Olson is set down.
Now batter, third baseman, Austin.
Austin Riley, next up for the Braves. 0 for 1, he struck out swinging last time.
Here's a fun fact. Dodger Stadium was also the home of the Los Angeles Angels for 4 years in the 1960s while they waited for Anaheim Stadium to be built. When the Angels were playing games at home, instead of Dodger Stadium, they called it Chavez Ravine Stadium.
And a swing and a miss. Not 2-1.
That's about as nasty of a splitter as you'll come across, especially in terms of movement. I mean, that thing tumbles out of his hand and just drops off the table at the last moment. If he keeps it down, it's just so tough to put wood on.
Ozuna, now in the box, comes up empty with a swing there. Not close with that one, and it's 1-1. Two down, nobody on. And he chases a high fastball there.
One ball.
Really just threw that fastball by him, elevated, and if you're not looking up in that location, very difficult to catch up to.
And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Braves go down quickly here, but they still lead it 3-2. It's game three of the National League Championship Series.
The left fielder.
Here's the left fielder, Teoscar Hernandez. The right-hander back to work. Swing and a miss. 1-1.
You know, these Dodgers showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. They're doing a good job of working the pitch count, and they've been able to push a couple of runs across to score as well. Still relatively early, but with a pair of runs already on the board, the ripple effect of that high pitch count might set them up to do more damage later in this game.
Field two.
One ball one. Two strikes.
That one down the line, and foul ball. The pitch.
That's ball two.
Gets a piece there. We'll do it again.
Always having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches still able to make some type of contact.
Down the line, Acuna after it. Snags it on the run. One away.
Now back, the designated hitter.
And now the DH, Andy Pajas. Singled and scored his first time. Fall off foul. And here it comes. Swing and a miss. 0-2.
0-2 is the count.
Line drive, base hit right field. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Everything came together for him. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way along the line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Enrique Hernandez steps to the plate for the Dodgers. There's a strike.
0-1.
Fouled off.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
The Braves leading by a run. We're here in the bottom of the fourth. And that's in the dirt.
But with the amount of pitches that can end up in the dirt, a good secondary lead doesn't have to get away from the catcher, but if you're anticipating based off
three.
And down on strikes he goes. Now two out. And here's the first baseman, Freddie Freeman.
Freddie Freeman.
There's a strike. Pajas off of first with two away. Ball one there. That one the other way. They get the force. Gets him easily. Ends the inning. One left for LA. They're down 3-2. Jared Kelnick now at the plate. He's already homered in this game. The pitch. Swing and a miss. He's 0-1.
Just not able to catch up to that velocity.
That one is upstairs.
Ball inside.
At the back door, too soon, it's strike two.
Man, that's just a nasty splitter. Bottom falls out of it. You don't see a lot of guys throw that these days, but I tell you what, he's got a good one.
Swing and a ball lifted left field. Calls it in, and there's one away.
Now that the catcher.
Sean. And now the catcher comes Murphy. Up to him. Sean Murphy struck out swinging his first time. There's a swing and a miss. Base is empty, one away. We're at the top of the fifth. That misses the zone, and the count is one and one. That's down and in. That misses the zone. They're down 3-1.
He hasn't fallen behind in the count like this all day. He's in danger of walking his first batter right here.
And a 3-1 on the way. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
From a pitcher's perspective, that's a beautiful splitter right there. As a hitter, you don't like it, but he's commanded his fastball, and out of that same tunnel, that splitter comes, and the bottom just falls out of it.
Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And now, Orlando Arcia. First time up, he grounded to third. Swing and a miss. That's strike one.
0-1 to the count.
The shortstop takes the ball. That one misses, and it's 2-1. Two outs. Pop foul out of play off to the right. Struck him out looking. Now the Braves go down quietly, but they're up 3-2. Plate for the Dodgers, James Outman. Singing, you gotta appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. That clips the inside corner for a strike.
He's so solid, calms the heart rate of the pitcher and the manager when the ball goes up in the air. You just automatically assume that it's an out every time it's hit in the air.
The 0-2. Swing and a miss. And one out now.
Very frustrating right there as a speedy potential base runner when with two strikes, you just struggle to put the ball in play. You don't even have to get a hit at that point. You can help your team just by reaching on an error, but some way you got to find a way to shorten up the swing and put the ball in play next time.
Here's Mookie to hit. Swing and a miss.
0-1.
Next offering misses. It's a ball and two strikes. Inside. Just missed.
It's a good take.
Turns and fires the bets. That one misses. And the count's full. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. One down, base is empty. Got him swinging. Here comes Max Muncy. A strikeout and a walk.
Max Muncy.
Swing and a miss.
0-1's the count.
That's a bullet, but it goes foul. And a pitch. Swings and misses, and the Dodgers are set down in order. Nothing doing for the Dodgers here. They trail it 3-2. Back to the leadoff spot in the Braves lineup. Here's Ronald Acuna Jr. at the plate. 1-for-2. The wind of the pitch. And that's outside. And that's ball one. A bit behind with that swing. It's strike one. The next pitch misses. Ball two. Swing and a miss.
Didn't recognize off speed. Thought it was fastball. A little bit out in front.
And another ball. Up the middle. There's Hernandez handling the chance. Throws to first in time. They get the out on Acuna.
Had to make the perfect play right there after that nice backhand stop, and he did. He couldn't have transferred the ball from his glove to his hand any better than he did. Just an excellent release.
Now in for the Braves, Ozzie Albies. He swings and fouls one off. Albies, a member of the 1,000 Hit Club, and he's a former Home Run Derby champ. And a pitch. Swings through that one.
That split is a pretty nasty pitch. Explodes out of the hand. Looks like a fastball, and the bottom just falls out of it.
Next one misses. One and two to count.
Good spot there, but didn't get the strike at the knees and doesn't seem too convinced by the call out there on the mound as he tries to get a better sense of the umpire strike zone.
And a 1-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. That's out number two.
Well, that splitter out of the hand, it just sort of jumps on you, and your interpretation is here comes a fastball again. Well, it never really reaches because the bottom falls out of it and you swing over the top, and that's why they call it a split finger fastball, because it looks like a four seamer.
Ground ball right side, and that's just foul. Why to kick the pitch? And a swing and a miss.
Quickly in an 0-2 count, you've got to figure out a way to shorten your path to the baseball. Put it in play somewhere, then you got a chance.
And downstairs.
Well, he missed badly with that 0-2 fastball. Hitter has to understand, probably wants to try to put him away with that pitch, so got to stay ready for it.
That one misses in the dirt. Swing and a miss. Curveball in the dirt. Smith gathers, throws. That completes the strikeout, inning over. Nothing across here this half. We go to the bottom half of inning number six, and the 5-6-7 slots do up. It's the Braves 3 and the Dodgers 2. Back now for the bottom of the sixth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Aaron Bummer. Well, one run game, and here's the catcher, Will Smith. Here comes a pitch. Just missed. That misses the zone, and now 2-0. Fouled off. He was late. Lifted in the air, right field. Sizes this one up. Pulls it down, and he makes the catch. And there's one down.
Up next to the dodgeball. The right fielder.
And now the right fielder, Jason Hayward.
Hayward.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is I want to stay square to the plate and try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
Throws to first in time.
Now batting. The left fielder, Teoscar.
Here's Teoscar Hernandez. That one finds the zone. Strike one. Two down, nobody on. Here in the bottom of the sixth. And that's off the inside edge. And it's a ball and a strike. And a foul ball. Goes down looking. Dodgers go down quietly. And it's still a 3-2 ball game. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Joe Kelly.
Now, power slider guy, bro. He throws it hard and gets a lot of late movement, so it's tough to pick up.
Kelly.
Matt Olson up to the plate.
The first baseman, Matt Olson.
And he deals. That one not close. 1-0. Activity in the bullpen. Alex Vesia getting ready to go. Chase that time. Three-one now. Swing and a miss at 99 miles an hour.
I guess you throw it that hard, you can get away with locations like that right down the middle. But I still think it's a dangerous pitch. Don't want to do it again.
He swung over top of the curveball. Chris, as we look back at the pitch sequence, he hadn't seen that curveball at all. How tough is it to adjust to something like that with a bunch of break when you haven't had a look at it yet?
Yeah, I mean, you're dialed up for something firm. You never want to take a called third strike as a fastball, so you're going to be a little anxious before you recognize the pitch. And right there, clearly didn't see what was coming.
Now at the plate, Austin Riley, who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts. Ball one, no strikes. Base is empty, one away here in the late stages of game three. And another ball.
Struggled a little bit in this one. Couple of strikeouts earlier, but doing a much better job in this at bat to get ahead and find a good hitter's count at 2-0.
Righty delivers. Swings through that one for strike one.
Man, 91 on the slider right there. That's a hard one. That's a low-end fastball for some pitchers.
Next offering in there for a strike. And the count is 2-2. One down, base is empty. Not even close there. And that's ball three. triple digits on that last pitch.
Third time he struck out in this one, and definitely an individual performance you want to flush. He just hasn't looked very comfortable up there. Just one of those days. But when you're still winning the ball game, at least you can focus on doing your part to maintain that lead and getting that W.
Next is the designated hitter, Marcell Ozuna. A swing and a miss, and that's strike one.
0-1.
Here comes the 0-1. Swings through that one for strike two.
0-2 is the count.
Two down, nobody on. Here in the top half of inning number seven. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Makes the catch. And that is that. Nothing doing here this half. Midway in inning number seven, and it's time to stretch. It's the Braves 3 and the Dodgers 2. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Joe Jimenez.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect a tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
The designated hitter.
One-run game, and now here's the Dodgers' designated hitter, Andy Pajas. In the air, left field. And a quick out, number one.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
Hernandez in the box here and lets that one go for a ball. Swing and a miss. And it's 1-1. Holding on to a one-run lead here at the bottom of the seventh. Left field. Coming. Gets there. He's under it. Calls it in for the out.
The first baseman, number 5.
So the lineup flips over. Freddie Freeman steps to the plate for the Dodgers. 0-for-3. A fly out, a ground out, and a strikeout. That's in there. Strike one.
0-1's the count.
Good eye in that spot. In the air to left, down the line. Kelnick brings it in with a nice running grab. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. J.P. Fireisen.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Well, one-run game. Jared Kelnick getting ready to hit. He's already homered here in this one. The pitch. Way high there. And that is ball one. Hey. And that gets the inside corner for a strike. Just off the inside edge. Kicks and deals. And another ball.
He
Right-handed reliever. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Leading off to the break, the catcher.
Now it's the Atlanta catcher, Sean Murphy. Swing and a foul straight back. That one missed. Action in the pen down there. Alex Vesia getting loose out there. Yarbrough warming up as well. Swing and a miss as he was late.
One ball, two strikes.
The 1-2. Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Slider got him for strike three.
They had him out in front, which isn't easy to do against a hitter like this, known for using the entire field. Just couldn't sit back long enough on that one.
Ryan Snitker making a move for a bat here. David Fletcher, runner on first with one down for him. Clips a corner. One run game, one out, one on. Comes up empty.
Well, you got the hitter already chasing that nasty slider. If you're on the mound, you just want to expand the zone right now. Get a swing and miss and get through this at bat.
Got it. And there are two outs.
We'll take a look at the three pitch sequence here. Pretty simple in terms of putting away at the plate. Once you're ahead 0-2 as a pitcher, you can really expand the zone and see how aggressive that hitter is going to be trying to protect and battle. And right there, clearly he was in swing mode, but all you can do is hope to foul that off.
And here is Ronald Acuna Jr., 1-for-3. Late on that fastball.
0-1.
Kelnick leads off first with two down to the inning. Starting after the 0-1 pitch, and now a check down to first. And yes, he offered at it. Righty to the plate. Not close with that one. And a count 1-2. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. So it's no runs, no hits, no errors, and a runner left. Last half of the eighth coming up. It's the Braves 3 and the Dodgers 2. So remaining in the game defensively, David Fletcher taking over as the new shortstop now following his pinch hit appearance. Tyler Matzek gets the ball now.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
And at the plate for the Dodgers, James Outman.
This guy, a player that, if he gets on base, has the ability to really be aggressive getting around the base paths.
Looking to get the tying run on base. The mark there, and the count even 1-1. On its way to the corner, and that's a foul ball. And the pitch. stays alive. Left-hand batter waits.
Two balls, two strikes.
With the call, and I think he got a little bit of favor on the mound. No question about it. It's not exactly what you want to see in a big spot like that, and I'm sure there's some chirping going on from the dugout, making it clear that wasn't his best call behind the plate today.
Here's Mookie Betts. In there at the knees. Strike one. One down, base is empty. Strike two.
No ball, two strikes.
Now a screamer into the outfield. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two down.
Well, off the bat, it looked like they might get that tying run on base. Maybe even extra bases. No dice, though. A little unlucky on that one.
And now it's Max Muncy. This guy with light tower power. There's a strike.
That big curve inside's a pitch that can buckle you a little bit. Looks like a fastball out of hand and then just drops over that inside part of the plate.
And there's a foul ball.
Very solid inning on the mound so far here in the eighth. Holding on to this narrow lead. This is a...
And he got him. Strike three, and that'll retire the side. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Alex Vesia. Well, one run game, and now it's the switch hitting second baseman, Ozzy Albies. 0 for 3 with two strikeouts and a ground out. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. That's strike one. Vesia, in his fifth season, he features a four-seam fastball, a slider, and he works in a changeup. And there's a ball. Swing and a miss. And the count, one and two. And they'll do it again. And that's outside. Two and two. The pitch. That's ripped. Base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Now, just a total nightmare for lefties. I'd be very surprised to see that matchup again. Nice line drive to the pole side. Met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
Met it first. And now the center fielder, Michael Harris. 0 for 3 with two strikeouts and a flyout. Makes in there. Chase's swing. Appeal down to third. And no swing, says Joe McDonald. One run game here at the top of the ninth. This one lifted in the air, left field. Calls it in, and there's one away. And now Matt Olson up to hit.
The first baseman, Matt Olson.
Yeah. out front with the swing, and that is strike one.
But this started in and ended up on the outside edge, just changing planes and very difficult, especially for a left-handed hitter to track.
Wouldn't chase that time. There's a swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
Off the mark there. Now 2-2. Goes down swinging for the strikeout. Slider got him for strike three.
Well, that right there is just a pitcher's pitch, tailing away from the hitter, blowing away with some good action at the end. You know, even if he gets the bat to that ball, it's probably just a weak ground ball to the opposite side. Tell you what, that's a tremendous two-strike pitch.
Austin Riley, the next to hit. Three strikeouts already. He's 0 for 3. He was late there. Strike one.
0-1 for count.
Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. Swings through that.
It's a tough day at the plate. Three strikeouts already. It's hard not to think negative, but you got to find a way to somehow center up the baseball and put it in play.
Two outs. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout. The runs, one hit, no errors, and a man left. 5, 6, and 7 will lead things off in the bottom of the ninth. It's the Braves 3 and the Dodgers 2. Back now as they hand the ball to a fresh arm to start the bottom of the ninth, Raisel Iglesias.
And I can't imagine any save is an easy one. You're holding a small lead on the scoreboard, and you know those hitters are going to give you the best at-bats they can. So it's always high stress. Let's see what he's got here to try and close it out.
Will Smith digs in now. The line of the pitch. In the air, right field. Acuna there. And out number one on the grab. That's a big first out right there, and that changes things.
Yeah, you can kind of see how just the hope and optimism has shrunk a little bit, but they got a couple more outs to work with. They got to find a way to get a runner on and get one around the bases.
Hayward in the box now. Takes strike one. Outside low, and that's ball one. A one-run lead here in the last half of inning number nine. And another ball.
An interesting situation. One swing, you can tie up the ball game. But if you're patient and work a walk, then you bring the game-winning run to the plate.
That's ripped into the outfield. And there's two away.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it. But in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
Swinging a foul over the screen and back out of play. And the 0-1. Just missed. Trying to close out a one-run lead. And the home team trying to pull it out. That's off the mark, but it's 2-1. On the ground at first. Steps on the bag himself. Ball game.
This team has been truly dominant in the series. Up now 3-0. Pretty demoralizing on the other side. You want to get this thing over as quickly as possible. So stay focused, come back for the next game, and close out this series.
Not a ton of offense to chat about as we look at the final numbers, but this was a good one.
Yeah, it was a low-scoring game, Boog, but sometimes those can be the best, especially this time of year.
A 3-2 final score in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show, thanks for stopping by. I'm John Ciambi. Talk to you soon.
the final line score for our ball game tonight. For the victorious Atlanta Braves, 3 runs, 5 hits, no errors. They left 2 runners on base.